Now, our first guest burst into the spotlight back in 1996 as one-fifth of the iconic girl band, the Spice Girls. Since then, she's become an accomplished solo artist in her own right, selling over 3 million solo albums worldwide. Her new single, taken from her fourth album, This Time, is out next week, and it's called Carolina. Never look back, never lose track, already strong. She seemed too much at 17. The past will fade. Please welcome Melanie C.
It's good to be back.
Caroline, tell us a bit about your new single.
Okay, well, this one is, it's one of the more up-tempo tracks on the album. And Carolina is a fictional character. And I was inspired, actually, by a documentary I saw in America a few years ago. It was about kids that had run away from home and were living on the streets in Seattle. And homelessness is something that, it just strikes a chord with me because, like everybody, you know, it's sacred. Mm. Home, a place, you know, to rest and to be safe and secure. And some people don't have that luxury.
We don't take it for granted a bit, don't we?
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, I wanted to do something which was more of a storytelling song because I'm always singing about, woe is me. My problems, me. So I thought, no, it'd be nice to do something different for a change.
Mm. And are homeless charities anything that you get involved with at all?
Yeah, actually, another song I had on my first album was called If That Were Me. That was also inspired by homelessness. And I work with a great charity called Can Do. And it's rehabilitates people who are on the street or in hostels and with addicts and, you know, lots of different situations through the arts. So people act and they make music and it just raises their self-esteem, and it's brilliant to see how people can grow from that.
And this song as well, just listening to that little track there, and I must admit, I came in earlier, you didn't see me, and I was listening to you rehearsing. This song, to me, is you getting back to your Melanie C roots. This is how I think of you performing. It's a little bit rocky, a little bit of hair flicking. Yeah. This is the kind of sound that I think people like to hear you make. Was that a deliberate choice for you?
You know, I always just follow my heart, you know, however I'm feeling. I'll just go with it. But, I mean, that's really nice to hear that. Mm. I've had some great feedback on this song, and, you know, fingers crossed, you know, lots of people seem to like it.
It's very catchy as well. And have you found that since you've been on tour? Have you just come back from Denmark? Is that right?
I had quite a hectic weekend just gone. I was, I played London last Wednesday. I played Denmark on the Friday. I was in Germany on the Saturday. And then I played the Isle of Wight on the Sunday.
Wow. I get your air miles.
Well, we had a private jet from Germany.
A private jet?
We did. I felt like Victoria Beckham.
Can we get this out of the way?
Go on.
The Spice Girls are not going to get back together, are they?
They might do.
Ah!
Well, I've had a little bit of a change of heart recently because there's been so many rumours. The last 7 years, it's constantly been in the press. Yep. And it's never been true until Live 8. You know, there was some truth in that because Sir Bob Geldof asked us if we'd do it and we were like, yeah, that'd be fantastic, a great thing to be involved with. Unfortunately, it didn't come together. And I think that just got people thinking and, you know, some of the girls have been up for doing it any time, and I was always like, oh, no.
You were always the one, really, that was holding back perhaps more than
the others. Yeah, I mean, it wasn't just me, you know. Yeah. Everybody had different things going on in their lives, as we still do. Yeah. But, you know, I just felt it's such a magical time, and I'm so frightened we can't do it justice, you know.
Wow.
But the feeling out there is really positive, and I just think, well, why not?
Well, you were the greatest girl band ever.
Ever.
Christmas to do that.
It'd be wonderful. So, you know, fingers crossed. It's, you know, it's looking like it could happen. There's a lot to sort out, but we've been talking about it.
Would you still wear track
suits, though? Would you try and move away? I always felt you, because I thought all the others, you know, they...
glamorous. And
yeah, they were viewing your tracksuit. You know what? But perhaps you didn't mind.
It's so comfortable, though.
I suppose so. And you have to think of these things.
Yeah. Yes.
So you're all posh spice now, aren't you? Private jets.
Actually, make Victoria wear the tracksuit.
Don't
you really love it?
Sure, she wouldn't have that.
I'm very ambitious. Is it an ambition thing?
Absolutely. Yeah, it's... I think... from my childhood, I mean, I don't know, you kind of analyse yourself, don't you, as you get older. And I think I've always been quite independent because my parents divorced when I was very young. And it made me quite determined to be something, what I saw as somebody and something and independent and my own person. And I just always loved performing, and that was just kind of my route of, you know, expression and also, you know, having confidence in myself.
Yeah. And because you are so independent, and maybe also because your parents got divorced, we were talking just earlier about cohabiting rights for couples. Mm-hmm. Is that something you believe in, rather than getting married, or do you think it should sort of stay the way it is at the moment?
I think we shouldn't... It shouldn't be, you know, one rule for everybody, because everybody's situation's different, you know, financially and in so many ways. You know, it depends, you know, what's happened. Why has the relationship broken down? I think if you choose to get married, then, you know, you're entering into that. But I think if you're living with somebody, we shouldn't all of a sudden have this law that...
You know, everything's equal. Because you've been with your chap now for 5 years, is that right?
Yeah, 5.5 years. And we have a home together, actually, in Wales. Uh-huh. So that's something, obviously, legally, you know, which is half his and it's half mine. But, you know, I'm loaded.
Yeah. He's having my money.
Exactly. So glad
you said that, love. You know, it is difficult, especially as women, because, you know, it's usually the women who go for the men, isn't it? But Nelsie is lauded, and she's not going to give up her cash for anybody.
And she's also...
And you're also going to be coming back later to perform your single, aren't you? But for now, it's Melanie C. For a break, but when we come back, we'll be invited to come dancing with Cheeky Twinkle Toes Brendan Cole. And of course, there'll be that fantastic performance from Melanie C. We'll see you in a bit.
Just another girl with a dream in her heart, wanna make a new start with the fire inside of her. She had to go. She couldn't stay around, everybody let her down, stole the light and the life and the child inside of her. She's so alone. Running for the train, take her far away from everything she knows and the way they make her feel. She leaves today. Never look back, never lose track, already strong. She's seen too much at 17. The past will fade with the future that she craves. Carolina, you travel so far, trying to escape the pain, start again where you are. Carolina, you keep following your star. Survive, had to keep your sanity, still feeling low, but she's never going home. Carolina, you travel so far, trying to escape the pain, start again where you are. Carolina, you keep following your star, nobody said you're beautiful. She needs is a warm caress. All she wants is happiness. Carolina,
trying to escape the pain.